Hello again. So happy you could join me on this beautiful day. I hope it's a beautiful day wherever you're at. What I got going on today is a pre-stretch canvas, 16 by 20. I spray painted it with your local hardware spray paint, but make sure you're in a well-ventilated area and you wear a mask. I sprayed it with all kinds of different colors. I think I'm going to do a blue snow-capped mountains with some trees and maybe some water down here. Who knows? This is a pre-stretch 16 by 20, and I loaded it up with a thin coat of liquid clear, and that's going to help the oils go on a lot smoother. And you'll see if you missed a spot, the oils will drag and makes it a little bit more difficult to do the blending. I'd like to start out by thanking all my viewers and subscribers. I really do appreciate it. This is my first painting for the year 2014. And any information and all the colors you'll need to paint along with me will come across the screen right about here, like always. So that's where I'm at so far. And let's do some, maybe a pink sunset. A pinkish sunset. We're using Alizarin Crimson and Liquid White. Maybe we'll just put it down here because the mountains are going to be up. So we'll put it right across here. Something like that. We're just going to blend this in. Get that pink hue. Pink and white look all the way across. Okay, get the blender brush. This brush really does a good job. It's really soft. We'll come in here and we'll blend this in all the way across. And if you notice, you might need some more color. And that's always okay. Come into some more of the darker pink. You want that hue look. Put the snow-capped mountains in. It's really going to make it look like a nice sunset there. Looks cold, but it's not going to be a cold sunset. It's going to have evergreen trees. Just going to be a pink hue to it. Pink hue. Bring in that blender brush, Bob. All the way across. Just blending it up. Clean that brush off a little bit. Come in with some just white. Brush again. Circular motions. That can be like where the horizon is. Okay. Take the same brush here and we're going to some purple colors. Some clouds. Maybe there'll be some clouds back in here. Darker. We'll take some of that off of there. A little bit too dark. way across. Got some things going on now. That just like that, and we'll come into some, I think some darker blues and maybe a purple. Mix it right on the knife. Just like that, little roll of paint. Come in here and we'll determine where we want our mountain to be. Scraping it in. Just like that. Clean the knife off. And we'll come in. This brush right here, we'll blend it down. Pulling it. Right where you think. Right where you think. Go into the blender brush and just tap it down here. I'm going to diffuse it and mist it. Get it that misty look. Into some white. Put a little bit of snow cap mountains on it. Little roll of paint right across that edge. All you're doing is tapping it. Paint right across that edge. Just tapping it right where you think. Right where you want that snow to be hitting. Back and through here. Back there. now. We'll take a little bit of blue. Blue and that white. Blending this in. Blending that in, getting that. Getting that reflection. Getting that shadow look off in the distance. Looks pretty good. I'll come in back in with the blender brush and just diffuse the bottom of this. Kind of make it misty before we start putting the trees in. Looks pretty good to me. Start putting some distant evergreen trees in this little fan brush. Come into some purple colors. Purples and blues, just like that. We'll come in the distance. What I'm doing is tapping down the corner of the brush. Make it look woodsy back there. Leave the gaps in between the mist. Because it gives different planes, different levels. Different levels. That misty look off in the distance. Just like that, where it just fades away. On both sides. Now we'll come in and we'll do another level closer. Except this time we'll get some green going, liquid clear, and some light green. We're off in the distance. This little fan brush here. Maybe an our world. That's too light. I want to darken it up some. Tapping. Make sure you leave those levels, distance in between them. Maybe over here we can have some. Darken it up a little bit. To look like a forest back there. Different levels, different sizes. Colors. Kind of got it woodsy back there now. It goes right off. Right off in the distance. Now. I think we could have come in and use this brush here. I'm gonna tap this down. A little smaller than the liner brush. You still have the same effect though, but you can get in there better. Sometimes you just have to try different things and seeing what works. All I'm doing is tapping, trying to get that mist. Trying to get that next level. That next level. Just like that. That is the next level. And it goes to the mountains. Let's get some brown going. I think we're gonna mix some Alizarin Crimson and Sap Green will give us a brown color. Mixing it. Get a little roll of paint. kind of determine where we want our land to be. We'll just put a little line there. Maybe over here it goes off. Comes off in the distance. Clean that palette knife off. Come into this brush here. Just come down and pull this right from where that is. Got that edge. Now we'll come in and get some white. Get some white on there. Just breaking that off there. You'll see when we come in, we get that brush going. It's going to bring this white down. And give you some colors all like the water. Fan brush. I use Oro's paint thinner, it's always a good thing. Clean off that little fan brush. Pretty good. Come right in and pull down this white. Just barely touching it. Gives it some reflection of the water. some of the reflection from the trees too. Pulling it down. Further down you pull it, the more reflection gets pulled down into the water. Step back. Maybe we can put some pinks in there. To emulate the sky. To get it to where it's the same. Blend that in. We'll blend some of that in too. Maybe that can be darker there. Maybe it goes into nowhere. Pull this down. Lightly go across. Step back and do it again, like we did the sky. Keep going back and forth till you get that look. Till you get that look you're looking for. Blends it right away when you put the blender brush on it. Clean off that brush. Come into some white, just white. Highlight this better. Blender brush. Tapping it. Line there, right up to the ledge. I like what's happening there. So, I think we can put a bird up there. Maybe an eagle. Maybe just a dark figure of a bird. Off in the distance. Use a liner brush. Maybe we can put a bird right here. Just by itself. Maybe it's an eagle. It's that simple. Now we're going to put something in here. see. Maybe put a peninsula in here. Peninsula with some we'll use this blender brush here. Get into some greens, blacks, darker color. Kind of get all kinds of little things going on this brush here. We'll tap in some trees. Make it all. Look at all got bushes and stuff. We'll put some evergreen trees in there. Clean off this blender brush. Let it soak. Then we'll come into this fan brush here. Get into some of the dark color, the greens, the blacks. Browns. And we'll put some evergreen trees in. One there. All I'm doing is tapping and going across back and forth. Way down just like that. Maybe there's one right here. Same thing. Leave gaps in between where you can see the water. Maybe that's that way. Maybe there's one up here, bigger one. Just tapping it down to get an idea where I want the trunk to be. And then I just tap across. You can make them as thin or as thick as you'd like. Just by tapping it. Just the way you think it might look. Nature. Another one right next to this one. I want this to look like a little forest here. A little peninsula. Darker colors all the way down. Everybody's got to do odd numbers. So I have to do an odd number. So I got four here, so we'll do another one. Maybe a taller one here. Maybe that one's pushed back. Maybe it's behind the trees in front here. Like that, just tapping this. Get some little stuff happening. That brown back there. It will bring it down, pull some reflections. Now we'll get the palette knife. Get some white in there. Little roll of paint. I'm gonna do just like the mountain. Maybe back there you don't see as much. Out of here. Clean it off. Got those dark colors on there. Get the excess off. Want it to be dry. Not have no thinner on it. Come in here and pull this down. grabbing right from the base. You're pulling that right down. Kind of like what we did up there. Tree colors going in there. Maybe some reflection of the trees. Just lately, what I did was I drew a line down, and then I'm using a little fan brush. And as I'm tapping that line, it's going away. But as yet, it's giving you somewhat of a reflection that we're looking for. Need some white. Right underneath here, like we did up there. And we'll pull that down. Same brush we used up there. I'll tell you what, let's use the fan brush. That's what we used to pull it down. Going right across, taking some of that off. Wiping the excess. Just that little fan brush we're using. Into the fan brush or the blender brush. Go right across. You can hear we can make it darker though. So I'm going to load this up. And make that darker. Darker right around there. And we'll see how that works when we pull that down. head all the way down. I think maybe darker. Need a darker in there. Need a darker there. We'll pull that down with the blender brush. Go across. Come into some white. Just scraping this little twigs and we'll get the little brush there. We'll get some things happening, some highlight. Highlight some areas. This brush right here. We'll load it up with some color. We'll load it up with some yellows. Yellow and white and liquid clear. Because a thin paint will stick to a thick paint every time. Use that one right there, that little sharp edge on there. Somewhat. We'll come into some pinks because we want the pinks to show up too. That pink color. Where this is coming through. Here and there, we've got some pink back there happening. In the front. Just like that. Now we can highlight this evergreen tree. Highlight it with some pink. Make it stand out just a little bit. Maybe there's some back here. Just a little bit. Just some of that pink shining through. Maybe they got some back here. Step back. Look at it. Find out. Okay, now we can probably put some flowers on here. Do some flowers is always nice. Some red flowers. Just tapping this. Maybe they come right out to the edge. Clean that off. Come into some blues. Some blue. Could be a light blue. Just like that. Oh, that's straight up. Gonna have to be a lighter blue, I think. Just a little hint, a little flavor of the blue. Got some flowers happening all along there. It's kind of going up. step back. And I think that might be a completed painting. I don't know if I should put something in here or not. Nope, I'm going to call it a completed painting. Know when to quit. Know when you did enough. Well, like I said, this is my first painting in 2014. I like to put my, I need to sign mine with my last name. Some people use her initials, and it's whatever you prefer. I always like putting the year in. This is the first one, 2014. I hope you enjoyed this one. More of a summer scene. It could be just about anywhere. But I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you come back and visit me the rest of the year. Bye.